How do you mean the inquiry? Has the coroner started another stunt? No. It's worse than that. It's the police. And it's worse than that, Charles. Again, Peter sunk his voice. They've got a man in from Scotland Yard. Then it was that for the first time for weeks, absolute sheer panic gripped Charles. He could not indeed speak, in spite of all his efforts. Motionless and sweating, he sat looking at Peter. But Peter was not looking at Charles. He was gazing vacantly down at the desk with an expression of extreme anxiety. Charles once again pulled himself together. Slowly he got to his feet and began to pace the room. "That's astounding news, Peter," he said, as soon as he could trust himself to speak. "Scotland Yard? How do you know?" "How do I know? Because the man's been with me. Very nice and very polite and all that, and asking questions world without end." "Good Lord," Charles exclaimed again. "Tell me." Peter shrugged. "That about covers it," he declared. "He came to the moat last night. The Scotland Yard man, he and a sergeant. It was after dinner, and he sent in an ordinary visiting card, Mr. Joseph French. I asked Weatherup what he was like, and Weatherup said he didn't know. He thought they were businessmen of some kind. I went into the study, and then the first one gave me another card. Detective Inspector French, Scotland Yard. I was surprised, as you can imagine, but I was more surprised when what he wanted came out. 'I've been sent down, sir,' he said, 'to make certain inquiries in connection with the death of the late Mr. Andrew Crowther.' 'Is suicide?' I said. 'Well, sir,' he answered, 'that's just the point. A question has arisen as to whether it really was or was not suicide, and that's what I've been instructed to inquire into.'